Boeing, a leading aerospace giant, recently announced the completion of the first upgraded FA-18 Super Hornet for the US Navy. This enhanced version of the Super Hornet is equipped with cutting-edge avionics, advanced computing systems, and a large area display, ensuring the aircraft remains at the forefront of defense technology. With these upgrades, the Navy Super Hornet fleet will maintain its operational capability well into the 2030s. The McDonnell Douglas FA-18 Hornet has been a cornerstone of the US Navy's aviation fleet since 1984. Its successor, the FA-18E/F Super Hornet, introduced in 2001, offers significant enhancements, including increased size, range, and advanced technology. Building on the proven technology of its predecessor, Boeing launched the FA-18E/F Super Hornet, also known as the Rhino, in 2001. This represents a substantial upgrade over the fourth-generation fighter aircraft. All Navy fighter squadrons have transitioned to the Super Hornet, which has successfully completed several combat deployments. Despite sharing a name, the Super Hornet is a distinctly different aircraft. It is approximately 20% larger and nearly 7,000 pounds heavier than the legacy Hornet, with improved capabilities and functionality. Additional hardpoints and more powerful engines enable it to carry more ordnance and extend its range, while redesigned engine intakes reduce its radar signature. The Advanced Mission Computer, or MC, processes more data at greater speed. These advancements have transformed the Super Hornet into an exceptional and reliable platform for the US Navy. However, like its predecessor, two decades after its introduction, the Navy recognizes the need for further upgrades. The upgraded version of the FA-18 is the Block 3 Super Hornet, which looks almost identical to its predecessor, Block 2, with no significant visual differences. One of the standout features of this fighter jet is its enhanced active electronically scanning array, or AESA radar, larger display screens, helmet-mounted queuing systems, and several avionics upgrades. Back in 2010, Boeing presented potential customers with the Block 3 International Roadmap, which included conformal fuel tanks, upgraded engines, enclosed weapons pods, a next-generation cockpit, a new missile warning system, and an internal infrared search and track system. One of the key advantages of Block 3, which is not directly related to combat, is its extended lifespan. Military aircraft spend a significant amount of time in both training and deployment, so every additional hour they can fly and fight is crucial. The Block 2 Super Hornet is expected to have a service life about 4,000 hours longer than the Block 2, increasing its total flight time from 6,000 to 10,000 hours. Internally, Block 2 offers a major upgrade for pilots, a customizable 10x19-inch touchscreen, replacing the four separate screens they'd previously had to manage. The capabilities of the Super Hornet have become even more formidable following the US Navy's announcement of a major breakthrough with the successful integration of the SM-6 missile into the carrier-based Super Hornet, now designated AIM-174B. This air-launched variant significantly extends the Super Hornet's air-to-air strike range, potentially reaching up to 300 miles, more than double the range of the current AIM-120D ROM. This development greatly enhances the Navy's combat abilities, particularly in air and surface warfare. The operational use of the AIM-174B is expected to be tested during the RIMPAC exercises, where its advanced capabilities could be showcased. This move aligns with the Navy's ongoing efforts to counter emerging threats from adversaries like China and strengthen its strategic position. The F/A-18 Super Hornet has proven its prowess by successfully destroying surface-to-air missile launchers in Iraq in 2002. Nicknamed the Rhino, the F/A-18 Super Hornet has been involved in close air support, strike missions, and aerial refueling operations during the Iraq War. It has also participated in continuous combat missions in Afghanistan, taking part in the fight against ISIS by striking the group's strongholds, conducting reconnaissance, and providing air control at the front lines. According to a report from Popular Mechanics, more than 500 Super Hornets have been built, with many more on the way. The U.S. Navy has ordered additional Super Hornets to fill the fighter gap as the older Hornets become obsolete. The Navy values the Super Hornet for its unique ability to perform buddy-to-buddy aerial refueling, allowing it to refuel other Super Hornets or compatible aircraft mid-air. This makes it capable of limited tactical tanker missions in combat zones, a critical capability when fuel becomes a pressing issue and traditional tankers cannot safely approach dangerous areas. This refueling capability is vital in dynamic combat environments where fuel management can become a crucial challenge. In these situations, dedicated tankers may be unable to approach due to high risk. Although the U.S. Navy now operates the F-35C for carrier-based combat missions, it continues to retain the F/A-18 Super Hornet for several strategic and operational reasons. First, the F/A-18 is a proven, reliable multirole aircraft that has served for decades. Its versatility in both air-to-air and air-to-ground operations makes it a critical component of the Navy's carrier air wings. Second, while the F-35C offers advanced stealth and sensor capabilities, its operational and maintenance costs are significantly higher compared to the F/A-18. The Navy values the Super Hornet's cost-effectiveness and durability, particularly for missions where stealth is not a primary requirement. Lastly, integrating the F-35C into full operational service is a gradual process, and the Navy must balance its legacy aircraft with newer platforms. By maintaining the F/A-18, the Navy ensures it has a diverse, capable fleet to meet a wide range of mission demands, while steadily increasing the F-35C role.